It's too late. It's too late, folks, because this early this morning, while I was in a semi-sleep state, I made contact with my guru. I made contact, direct contact. And, of course, woke up this morning, and more troubles in the world, right? But it's too late. It's too late. I can tell you, I will tell you what happened. I will tell you what happened. All day long, I've been taping on my MP3 tape recorder. Incredibly great stuff. Just mind-blowing stuff. I don't know, I can condense it down. Hours and hours of taping. I understand what's going on. Can I explain it to others? Probably not. Won't sink in. But I can try a little bit. But I've sorted it out for myself. I see what is going on. In essence, what's going on is the ego is telling us that the area of our mind where truth abides, where the guru principle is, where the Holy Spirit is, that area of the mind, the ego says, doesn't exist. And what its goal is to develop a culture and a society and a focus that agrees with this, that this area simply doesn't exist at all. What happens then to the people who want to access this area, this all-important area of the mind, actually? The ego says that they're crazy, that they're delusional, that they're psychotic, etc., and they need therapy. Therapy. I can get into, I can do a whole thing on this, what's going on with that, but to shorten up the video for you, that's where we're headed. And fortunately, last night in this dream, I was able to directly access that area of the mind, directly access and directly communicate with the guru principle, my guru. And what happened was, we were in this stall, marketplace stall, as it were, by a roadside. Like in India, you see the road, and then there's all these stalls along the road with open to the, you know, open to the road. And we're in this kind of room, like a satsang kind of room, behind the front counter of some stall or something. And I was watching this big screen, big television set, watching it. And at first, there were pictures of my guru on the television set. And I was watching, saying, "It's wonderful, this is wonderful, this is wonderful, wow, so incredible." And then what happened was, somehow the channel changed. Someone changed the channel. I'm saying, "Oh, what's this?" It's like, "Oh my God." And it changed from pictures of the guru to this horrible, macabre, this half-open coffin with this person in the coffin. Half of their body was rotting away, and the other half was still alive, and they were talking, and someone was coming up and worshiping and kissing them, saying, "Oh, you're so wonderful." And it, I call it the NPC, the necrophiliac channel. These people loving death, and the all the stuff, the content on the television now was about all these necrophiliacs loving death and rottenness. And I said, "Well, what's this?" I said, "Wait a minute, I don't want to see this. Go back, change the channel back." And it didn't change. And I protested. I said, "Wait, hey," yelling in the room, "what's going on? Come on, this stuff's terrible. Get change the channel back." Nothing happened. So finally, I finally was so disgusted. I said, "I can't take this anymore. I cannot take this anymore." And then I turned my attention off the television to the back of the room. And there was the guru was just standing in the back of the room, just very quiet, not saying anything. And I said, "Hey, guru, I can't take this anymore. Please change the channel for me." And the guru said, "Well, you know, didn't respond. I said, hey, change the channel. I can't take this. Change it back the way it was. And the guru then said, it marks the spirit of this time. This channel now marks the spirit of this time. And that's what you're seeing now on the channel. And they can't change it back. They can't change the channel. So at that moment, I said, well, okay. I'll tell you what, Guru, I know what I want you to do, if you can't change the channel, what I want you to do for me is let's go take a walk. Let's go outside and take a walk. Let's just take a walk. Lead us on a walk. And the Guru said, that's a very good idea. Yes, I'll do that. Let's go. And so I and some others got up and the Guru and we walked outside the stall, out into the road. And then I was kind of looking like, which way do we go? Okay, and the Guru was kind of like, kind of going from foot to foot a little bit. And I said, okay, where are we going? And the Guru was in no hurry to go off in any direction. It was just kind of hanging out there outside the stall. That was the dream. Now, it's actually an amazing dream. And I understand what it means. The stall is the world. And the stalling is the delay of the ego, which is the world. It's a means of delay. And the video channel is the culture. I mean, the television channel is the culture of the world. And the world has gone into this necrophiliac mania. Now, I thought for sure the channel would change back because people would just say, this, we can't tolerate this. This is absolutely terrible. But no, excuse me, but no. No change back. It's getting worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. And I tell you, what you're seeing in the culture of the world is literally a love of death. That is a fact. And I said, you know what, I can't tolerate that anymore. I've been watching, hoping it would change, and hoping I could change it. I could change the channel back to what it used to be. And I've put so much effort into that, actually. And I haven't been able to do it. So I thought I could do it. I thought, because I've had experience in the past working within culture to help elevate culture. And so I thought I could at least do something helpful to elevate the culture. I'm unable to. I mean, when you're dealing with necrophiliacs, it's a whole different ballgame. I didn't realize how bad it can get. So, finally I couldn't take anymore. In other words, I can't take any more of this culture. It's too terrible for me. I said, that's enough. I cannot take it anymore. I said, let's take a walk. Guru, would you please lead us on a walk? Now, what does that mean? This Guru said, yeah. He said, that's a great idea. I'll do that. And so, where does this walk mean? Well, we walked out of the stall onto the road. That means, somehow, I believe, getting off of this planet, out into space somewhere. And then instead of going somewhere, we just kind of hung out there. Just kind of hung out. At least we're outside of the world where we can't hear the television. We're not aware of what's on the television channel. So we didn't necessarily go someplace far away. We kind of hung out within the vicinity, as it were. So that's how I see it. That's how I see it. Now, here's something to consider. The guru principle manifests at times in this world very powerfully. And when it does, the body is seen in this world. The guru principle I think I've been used. I think I've been used, you know? Because the ego has targeted these people who are actually very bright and capable of enlightenment, but is using them, thinking, hey, you can have a higher position and help more people if you do this sort of fake guru thing. But really, they're capable of salvation. They are. I see, I acknowledge that. Absolutely, they are. But they've been tricked. The only difference that for me is I experienced directly that the mutual exclusives is impossible. And so I could not become one of those fake gurus. It's not possible at that point. But if not for that, I would have become one of them. I would have been tricked, for sure. Does that mean I've been capable? No. You know, it's just that I didn't quite have the leverage. So at some point, a lot of these top, satsang, quote-unquote, therapists who are leading people away to the ego will have remorse and say, whoa, we've been used, we've been tricked. And they'll feel very, very lost and hopeless and suicidal, so to speak. At that point in time, those who have taken the walk with the guru can come back on the scene and say, look, we know exactly what happened. We've sorted it all out. And we're clear as a bell, and you know, you can. All is forgiven, there's no worries. We'll give you real therapy. You can really enter into real therapy at this point. And they will say, okay, yeah, absolutely. So again, there's no hatred or judgment toward these people at all. I understand that their fear of the continuity issue is causing the problem, and the lack of leverage over the ego is causing them to grab a hold of this opportunity that seems like aligning with enlightenment, even though it's actually the ego's using them. It's a funny thing in this world. What's happening? Because what happened was the radical feminist, the whole feminist movement, really was double-crossing men. Men got double-crossed by women in this world. No question about it. Just watching the whole thing, I couldn't believe it. My gosh, it's a total double-cross. They're just saying. But, see, they made a deal with the extraterrestrials, actually. Why? Because they plan on double-crossing the extraterrestrials. That's a fact. See, women are very shrewd, and they really believe that they're capable of double-crossing anyone and having it both ways. So they said to the men, look, they didn't tell the men they made a deal, because they said, later on, when we double-cross the extraterrestrials, it'll be great for men. We'll be able to make it up to them, you know. But what they don't realize, or they kind of do, is that the extraterrestrials who they made a deal with are actually going to double-cross them. And they're not going to get what they thought they were going to get. But you see, they think they can win. They think that they're going to be able to double-cross the ETs, and the ETs think they're going to be able to double-cross them. And the men were supposed to be just on the sidelines, you know, and we're supposed to think that nothing has happened. So they're telling us nothing has happened, but they actually made a deal with the ETs, which is, you know, kind of double-crossing the men. And the kicker of the whole thing, which should provide us a good laugh, is that the ego is actually going to double-cross everyone. That's what's going to happen. The ego is going to double-cross the ETs, and the ego is going to double-cross the women. Okay, and of course the men are just going to be, you know, thrown in the trash bin, so to speak. At least that's what the ego's plan is. You know, the ego's going to double-cross everyone. That's funny. You know, these double-crossers, you know, there's this furious battle. I mean, there's a struggle for the planet, because women said they're going to help the ETs gain control of this planet if they put the women in charge. But what happens is, once the women are in charge, they're going to double-cross the ETs and say, no, you can't come here. And then they're going to go to the men, look what we've done. This is the Eve thing. Look, I've tricked them. And look at all the technology, everything we got. Isn't it wonderful? We have a wonderful place now. See? But the ETs said to the women, look, we're going to put you in charge, and we just want a little help here and there and there. But they're going to double-cross the women and take over the planet for themselves. You see? That's their double-cross. So both sides are trying to double-cross each other, and then they're in this furious dance, you know, of deception, trying to get to the double-cross. And then here's the ego behind the whole thing, double-crossing both of them. And you gotta have a sense of humor about it, because it's pretty funny. In the big picture, the ego's deceiving everyone. Because what it really is leading everybody to, and they don't realize this, is this mutual exclusive thing. And that's a real hell. I mean, that's doesn't get any worse than that. And the ego's saying, oh no, we're advancing, everything's advancing, you know, and blah, 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 blah. Tolerance, love, fairness, equality, you know, all these things. And it's really advancing us towards the state of entertaining mutual exclusives in our mind. And that gives you the experience of this total chaos, total sense of disorientation. It is an absolutely horrendous. That's what it's really leading everyone to. and each one thinks that the ego is on their side, is helping them double cross the other. So this is really what's taking place in the world, all this double crossing. And yeah, so it's very complex, right? And difficult to sort out. And things keep kind of going this way and that way, and like, wow, you know, what's happening here? What is all these double crosses? But again, the females of this planet, the feminine principle, made a deal with the ETs. Absolutely, they made a deal. And because they thought they could double cross them, and that they would then have their cake and eat it too. That they would be in charge, and that the men wouldn't mind because they brought all this wonderful materialistic advancement into the planet. And that they've become so wonderful, such beautiful partners, such wonderful partners now, because they've been empowered, and you know, and all this, you know, they're going to be so much better. And men will just say, "Wow, what a great deal! What a great partner I have now." But it doesn't turn out that way, because the ETs are double crossing them, and the ego's double crossing both. And so, you know, it's the Eve thing. The Eve is very shrewd, and thinks that she can help out Adam. You know, it doesn't work out. It turns out very badly for both of them. Very badly. And men, what are they doing? They're just confused. They don't know what the heck's going on. They really don't. They're just confused. They know something's just crazy, but they don't know what it is. They really don't, unfortunately. They're trying to figure it out, you know. It's like, maybe it's, you know, it's just this guy, you know, he's the bad guy. The president, he's the bad guy. Or this, you know, they're trying to pin it on somebody. They can't figure out. They're trying to say all this terrible stuff. It's right. It's them. It's this person or something. And they're confused. They're confused. They don't know what's going on. You only know what's going on if you've had access to the Holy Spirit and the subtle level of mind and have the leverage over the ego. If you've seen that, then you see it as plain as day. It's plain as day. It's always been plain as day to me. Otherwise, the men are just like, you know, like, wow, what's going on? When women first made the deal with the extraterrestrials, they were so scared that men would recognize what's happening. And so what they did is they love bombed men. They love bombed them. That's when the ETs gave them the birth control pill. Actually, ETs worked through many people on this planet, including the pharmaceutical, the chemists, and all this stuff. And they've helped develop these medicines, pills, pharmaceuticals, etc., along with a lot of other things, actually. They developed the birth control pill. And then they told the women, listen, you know, the men don't dare catch wind of what's going on here. So you gotta love bomb them. You gotta love bomb. So what happened was, we got love bombed by the women of the world. Once the pill came out, the women said, hey, guess what, guys? Is the greatest thing that's ever happened. Unlimited sex. Okay. Whenever you want, it's, you know, great, let's go for it. And the women became sex maniacs, actually. And men are just like, oh, what the heck's going on? Oh, this is great. You know, it's like a child is whining, complaining, and the mother says, here's a lollipop, you know, here's a lollipop.